And that's the end of the match. The West Indies have won this test match by 408 runs. The first time any West Indian team has won a test series in Australia.
Cricket was known as a gentleman's game in the days before independence of the British West Indies. After the abolition of slavery, people were hungry for mental emancipation. For the former colonies, the opportunity came in the form of cricket. The scenes left by slavery were still very present, racism and oppression still occurring throughout the world. It was like stepping into old Malcolm territory with the masters of the game for the former colonial rulers. The first step to achieving autonomy was the selection of the first ever black West Indian captain, Sir Frank Worrell, in 1960.
Before independence, it was a colonial, we were colonies, so it was a colonial game, and which we all played. So Jamaica, Trinidad, Guyana, Barbados. Identity then was one of independence. We then became very nationalistic, and so cricket was one of the bases for it, because the only things that kept the West Indies united in those days was cricket. That afterwards, being sovereign nations, cricket was the glue that stuck those sovereign nations together and made for a West Indian identity.
At this point, the West Indian cricket team were winning some but losing most. They were taunted and stigmatized for their skin color and identity, and their crushing defeat by Australia cemented the fact that there was much work needed to be done.
West Indies cricket term is more significant, or became more significant after, because we were sovereign nations that got together to play cricket together. While before that, we were British West Indies. So we were just a bunch of colonies playing together, supported by the Englishmen, our owners, so to speak. So it wasn't really self-reliance.
With the introduction of Clive Lloyd, the West Indies cricket team came back better and stronger than ever, defeating the English cricket team in 1976. This victory meant more than just a trophy and bragging rings. It destroyed the barrier between the whites and blacks and showed that it was a game meant for every person of every race.
Then they played this marvelous cricket that they enjoyed and they loved seeing and watching. So our legacy then was everybody wanted to see the West Indies play because of the excitement and the way they played. Then everybody wanted to see us play because we were demolishing everyone. That was as recent as the 90s, 20 years ago. We were playing hard cricket, we developed the cricket and the pride and everything. And we were playing very, very bright and exciting cricket, and we were winning. So everybody wanted to play us too, so they could beat us. And that's how they measured their success, by how they played against the West Indies.
At this time, apartheid was occurring in South Africa, and the entire free black world felt the call of the oppressed peoples. Clive Lloyd and his team were very much a part of the struggle, identified with their ancestors, and refusing to play when the team was asked to participate in a test match in South Africa.
No, I think what has happened is the less test matches and so on is a whole political, economic type of arrangement. Some of the stronger nations economically, and when I say economically, I'm talking about cricket-wise, taking advantage of those who are not as strong economically. And because people like in the West Indies, we are a bunch of small territories, and our grounds are small and hold 15,000, the countries are not as rich as the bigger countries. For everybody to pay a big sum to come in to watch cricket. So you're not going to make money at the gate. The television rights, which really drives the financial value of the game, we don't have that sort of capacity. So we have to stoop and bow to India and England and Australia and the people with the money. And I believe it's the administration of cricket that let it fall on the wayside and did not understand the game. Too many people who didn't understand the game and what the background was, where we came from, what we were planning to do, how we're going forward. They just thought it would have been there all the time.
Cricket helped in building Caribbean identity. It helped uniting the British West Indies as the people who shared a common background of oppression and discrimination. Cricket united the free world and paved the way for the younger generation. Brian Lara, Chris Gayle, Darren Bravo, and the hundreds of others that will come to represent our region as one common people, united and free of the throes of hardship.
Champion, champion.